Mark Marquez is the most skilled rider, and he definitely leans. Yet, iron butts log the most miles, and they stay neutral. Of course, body position is most influential in supermoto, and sumos counterlean.
Huh. How does the same problem, with the same rules, have three different solutions? It doesn't. Gravity always pulls our tire down. The ground normally says,
"No way! I'ma push it back up."
So we call that normal force. When I turn in, our reference frame starts turning, creating the illusion of a force pushing outward that we call centrifugal. But physics is like politics. It puts real effort into fighting imaginary forces. So our friction patch pushes back inward toward the center of the curve.
Gravity, normal, centrifugal, friction. Got it.
Of course, friction and ground forces happen down here at the contact patch. But gravity and centrifugal forces operate on the center of mass, which is somewhere, well, it's about here. Well, I'm not saying I have massive testicles or anything.
They're huge.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They're too big. They're freaky. It's weird.
Fail to lean, and your gravity and ground forces cancel each other, meaning the friction and centrifugal arrows work together to flip your bike away from the turn. It's enough to flip James Bond, as it were. That's why motorcycles lean, to get their center of gravity and normal forces off axis, so the bike wants to fall down as much as it wants to fall up. Equilibrium.
Congratulations! Now we all know how to draw a man humping a football.
Oh, yeah.
But equally important is that we're poised to answer why one might lean their center of gravity further this way or further this way. So, as the man with two penises says, where would you like to start?
The obvious way to corner quickly is to carve as fast as possible. But one can also enter as fast as possible, pivot, then pull out hard. Giggity. Taking a U or V-shaped path depends on whether you fancy your motorcycle better in a turn or better in a straight line. Consider MotoGP with its bubblegum tires and lollipop curves as the epitome of corner speed.
If we want fast centripetal acceleration, we need to force more friction. And if we have more friction, we need to balance that with more gravity. But how?
Holding the race on Jupiter would work, but also not. Eating an extra large poutine mid-corner would work, but also not. Adding downforce with aerodynamics does work, but only if you have Ducati's MotoGP budget.
Damn, increasing gravitational force is a tad impractical. So, why don't we just move it inward where it levers more effectively? And I can accomplish this by leaning the bike more. Though there comes a life-changing moment where one runs out of tires, so we lean our bodies instead. More lean allows for more friction force, creating a faster turn.
The only downside is sluggish changes of direction. None of these men are Shakira, so they take a while to move their torsos from one extreme to the other. Hence, rapid pivots are faster when counter-leaning. An upright body never has to move. See, dirt bikes, like most bikes, are stronger in a straight line. So they brake late, counter-lean to get the direction change done quick, then blast out. The only question you need to ask is whether an average street bike on street tires on public streets will be faster in a curve or a straight line. The answer is usually the latter, so counterleaning is usually faster. Life-saving, evasive maneuvers are quicker when counterleaning. This we know.
And if you hit Bambi, or some ice, or your own brakes, the danger in most emergencies is a loss of grip, in which case these forces vanish. This'll slam me to Earth faster than a Chinese rocket, unless I stay neutral? No, that doesn't help. I lean? No, that makes it worse. Again, we need to counter lean.
Yet another reason why riders do it, so they can balance and save slides. Even the MotoGP monkeys, when they lose grip, will extend their outside leg in a last-ditch effort to shift their center of gravity outwards.
And counter-leaning not only saves a dire situation, it can help you avoid one. See, if I'm tucking down here, my view is only left, like Vonk's. Whereas when I counter-lean, I'm high enough to see the whole bloody mess.
This is why motor cops are trained to counter-lean.
As a retired police instructor and major crash investigator, we teach some unique skills to our police riders and civilian riders, and one of those is counterbalance. So counterbalance is the technique where the rider sits upright and leans the motorcycle over rather than leaning in with the motorcycle. This changes composite center of gravity of the bike and improves the stability of the motorcycle. We see this in low speed techniques really easily, but at high speed, the same effect happens to give us improved balance, vision, braking, and stability.
Counterleaning might look wrong to most riders, but the finest know it's usually right.
Now, before the Americans sue my antlers off, of course you should lean if you're actually approaching maximum corner speed, or if you don't trust the edges of your tires and want to keep the bike more upright, or if you want to have fun in a pleasure activity that's a completely legitimate choice that I make daily. Thanks.